quick update. I have legs for R2 mostly put together. I'm missing a couple caps, just, you know, drink caps that I used on the end of these pipes. I just have to tell the kids to drink more juice faster. And then I clayed up the little cracks and things between the wood. That's all dry and it's sanded. And so now I'm going to take some white spray paint and spray it. I'll do the last cap later. That's no big deal. And then I need to start painting the rest of the robotic parts on him. This is it as far as structural. The rest is just gonna be painted details. So I'm gonna do that. It's gonna be super hot today, so it's a good chance that I'll get a lot of painting done because all the layers will be drying quickly. Here's our little crumb dude. He's taking forever to dry because he's got quite a bit of clay on his body. He's almost done. His ears need to be built up. I do those slowly just so that the clay has a chance to dry and it's not gonna break off. So he's coming good. He's just on the rest of the foam, like I mentioned before. I'll cut him off. It's just easier to prop him up because he's clayed all the way around, and there's really no nice way of doing that other than putting a hole up the middle and doing like a post like I normally do, but my post kind of got messed up, so I'm gonna do it this way. And then right now I'm going to work on Han Solo and carbonite. His face is left and a little bit more on his hands, and then I can sand that up, seal it, and then start painting. That's gonna be such an easy paint. I love it. Just gonna be the shiny gray, and then that's it. And then over here, this is the start of Jabba the Hutt. So excited to do him. This is gonna be like the neck up, so like his head. I gotta build that up. I'm gonna use chicken wire, paper mache over that, and then do my claying for the face. And then I got a plan for the body, just to make it really, really easy. Just more chicken wire and more paper mache, not even clay. I don't think I'm gonna need to. Kind of like the way I did the snake years ago for the Harry Potter haunt. So anyway, these are the projects for today. More if we have time. And I'll talk to you guys real soon. Okay, Star Wars fans. Here's the very beginnings of paper macheing Jabba the Hutt. So I have chicken wire kind of draped around a very large pot, plastic pot, like, you know, plant pot. It's just propped up on a stool that I have just to get the height right, which is what the platform we're going to make for him. This is just the head part, and then you can see the arms sticking out. And so it's just regular paper mache, newspaper, and water and glue, white glue. And I draped it all over. I think I did almost two layers on everywhere, not quite, but I was fighting the wind one day and I didn't get everything, but he's pretty much dry with a couple spots. Let me rotate around and you can see. And then I started claying, actually, paper mache claying the back. And so this is one batch. So it's like three toilet paper rolls of paper mache clay. And I just, you know, got it on him, and then I used a skewer just to kind of get some lines like for his skin. And so I've got quite a ways to go, and I'm guessing he's gonna be four, maybe five batches of clay, because he's pretty big. And so like the eyes and everything that I have to do real sculpting on will come later. Right now I'm just doing a layer all the way over the paper mache just to get the clay on, get them hardened up, and then I can start doing like the facial features and stuff, and then like the fingers for the arms and everything. So right now he's just, he was dry, but with the moisture in the morning, he gets a little bit wet, but then he dries again, and then I can keep going with the clay. So anyway, there's Jabba the Hutt. He's pretty cool. He's big. And then I will make a separate section this way with chicken wire for the rest of his body. And so, okay, so I'll show you more very soon. Okay, here's the progress on Han Solo. He is done as far as clay goes. I finished his face, his hands, his neck. It's pretty close. People, especially faces, are hard for me, so I got it as close as I could. I think it's convincing. And so now I have my asphalt sealer. This is the brand that I use. And I sanded him, and now I am sealing him. So he'll dry today, and I might as well just seal the wood too. This is an old door, it's kind of falling apart. I mean, it's still intact, but there's a little layer that's kind of shaving off. But I'm gonna seal this whole thing up, let it dry, and then we're gonna put the cool gray color on it. After it's got a protection layer here. And I'm pretty generous with this sealant. Like, I'm shoving it into all the little crevices and corners and pockets, because I really want this, because I think we're gonna actually put this scene outside. So if it does happen to get moist or wet, then it won't fall apart, because I mean, all this clay is basically water-based, so it can get mushy and be destroyed. But with this sealer, it really locks in the clay, and I haven't had any problem except for one character that had a little pocket, a little leak where the water got in. And I will fix that character. It's Buckbeak from Harry Potter. Very attached to that guy. So I will fix this, just his wings. But everything else that I've ever made has always been good to go. And I mean, like, pouring rain. It's no problems whatsoever. So yeah, I'm just gonna seal him up, and then he'll dry completely, and then we'll go from there.